email address. I've got your email address, so
my face goes here. But what?
Does that not work?
Rolling Stones.
Yes, ma'am.
My face goes here.
On the front.
Not in here.
Okay.
It goes here.
No, Viva,
it doesn't work.
Nopongo from Rolling Stone SA.
Hi.
I wanted to ask about...
Can I just interrupt there?
Yes.
Can I just interrupt there? It's the finest music magazine in Africa, Rolling Stone magazine. Although one associates Rolling Stone with rock and so forth, there are some incredibly good articles. And if you haven't seen the magazine or subscribed as yet, and I don't work for Rolling Stone myself either, but it is the finest music magazine in Africa today.
Well, there you go.
Papa was a what?
Gender equality in your music without being sort of too heavy in your fans' faces.
I'm afraid to call myself a feminist because I don't even know, you know, like if the feminists will agree with my type of feminism, the beat, the style.
All generations, you know, like from the grandmother to the baby, everybody loved me.
I don't sound like anyone else.
I feel like big things happened to me at a young age and I still have to...
They can't do me, you know what I mean?
You know. Yeah, and I still have to stay grounded, you know, I still have to move, it's a journey, you know.
I'm afraid to call myself an activist because I don't know if there's a certain level of activism that you must do to consider yourself an activist. The style. You know, I think I just keep it simple and that's how it works. The beat, type.
The audience members keep saying, if you say jazz festival, then we expect jazz.
Jazz music became the music of resistance because a lot of our jazz musicians ended up being exiled. A lot of them moved to other countries in the world. So it was the music of, you know, of longing, of resistance, of displacement. That's what I think it represents to me as a young South African musician.
Because my music is all about, I guess, unpacking the black issues.
I think it's always been about resistance. Consider myself, you know, a child of the rebellion, you know, like tainted with that. And I've always, just because of that year, 76, I always felt that, I feel like it did taint me. It did add something to who I am in type.
So it's uprising with 1976.
Yes.
And you were born in 1976. And independent year is 1994.
Yes.
1994, you are 18.
Yes.
So before apartheid and after apartheid, what different for you?
Difference?
Change?
Not much change. But the big change is in my mind type. The realization that I am a free person. That's the main change. But if you look, not much has changed. But I think the change is happening here type. Black people are starting to recognize that the world is theirs as well. You know, that it's not just for white people. It's also for us. happened in this country is we won a very difficult war, and we are victors of that war, and now we must start acting like it. Type.
The other day I tweeted that God so loved the world that she gave it music, you know, and that's how I feel. I feel like everything is sound. Sound moves things. It moves, you know. We can move the entire universe with sound. So it is a very spiritual thing, because once you're a musician, or even as an audience member, you realize that something spiritual happens, you know, when the right kind of chemistry is put together, you know. Do you need more?
You look like you're not satisfied.
Yes, I really need more, because I record your voice and I really want my audience can understand what the really meaning for you personally.
Yes. Okay, maybe I'll talk to you later after, you know, and then I'll
okay,
give
personal.
You a, yes, and I'll
yeah,
I'll
yeah.
give you a
yeah. Down.
Gentlemen at the back.